explain it all to you because they want you to be comfortable.
As you can see here, this is an agreement that a typical client would look at. But first thing you'll notice is that it's a non-sexual experience.
Oh, what's the point?
You feel very exposed right now.
Yeah, I do. I very much do.
Is it okay if I put my body against yours? Okay.
We have a lot of opinions about what we think and feel about it. It is a little close for comfort, but let's see what the outcome is.
I'm feeling okay. That was very relaxing. It did take me a while to sink into it.
I feel like we went from like strangers to best friends like that.
It was like, yeah, these people can't faze me, but when you're actually being held by a stranger, it opens you up to a lot of like truth.
Have a great weekend, everybody. We'll see you on the next Right This Minute.
More wind and more quick-moving showers tonight. We eventually see a change in our weather pattern as we get into the second half of the weekend. We'll take a look at that and your weekend forecast in detail at 11.
You're my buddy, my pal, my friend. It will be that way until
making the most out of every mile. That's why I got a Subaru Impreza.
Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
Lease the Forester for just $119 a month at Schumacher Subaru.
Cell phones and texting cause one in every five accidents. In the time it takes to text LOL, you could end up DOA. Texting and driving can get you killed. Let's get that message out.
The attorneys of Cersei Denny, taking time to care.
Just in time for the holidays, interest rates are going down, way down, all the way down to zero at Rooms To Go, which means you can finance great-looking furniture starting as low as $5.99 for just $10 a month interest-free. Really, not one penny of interest until December 2020, 60 months from now. There's no interest adding up. Just make equal monthly payments until December 2020. So hurry to Rooms To Go, because the 60-month interest-free finance offer ends Monday.
The perfect car calls for the perfect price, and Lexus of Palm Beach has it. During the Lexus December to Remember sales event, lease a new 2016 Lexus ES350 or new RX350, your choice, only $300 a month. Plus, Friday through Sunday only, get an HD TV with any new Lexus. Only at Lexus of Palm Beach, an AutoNation company and proud supporter of the AutoNation Cure Bowl. Visit LexusofPalmBeach.com.
Happy Thanksgiving, one and all. It's time again to release the hounds. John O'Hurley here with David Frei as we celebrate this special holiday tradition. The pointer wins it.
The Wire Fox Terrier.
The beautiful Ira.
Scottish Terrier, best in show. Yes, welcome to the 2015 National Dog Show presented by Purina, hosted by the Kennel Club of Philadelphia. Today we're here at the Greater Philadelphia Expo Center, home of the National Dog Show. David, our hounds, take us down the line.
There's the Afghan hound, the Saluki, the Abethan hound, the Faro hound, one of our seven new breeds today. This is the Cherneco del Etna. There's the recognizable greyhound, the Whippet, the Borzoi, the Scottish Deerhound, the Irish Wolfhound, the American Foxhound, the English Foxhound, and here are our two beagles, the 15-inch beagle and the 13-inch beagle. Who doesn't love a beagle? The Rhodesian Ridgeback, the Norwegian Elkhound, the Basenji, the Portuguese Podengo Pequeno, the Blue Tick Coonhound, the Treeing Walker Coonhound, the Bloodhound, the Otterhound talking to us, the Petit Basset Griffon Vendéen, the Basset Hound, and the three Dachshunds, the Smooth, the Long-Haired, and the Wire-Haired. 32 breeds in the hound group. Originally, we're all sporting dogs, actually, because they're hunters. The sight hounds hunt by sight, the scent hounds using their nose to follow their prey, but they would hunt anything from moose and bear on down to rabbits. They're courageous, single-minded, great dogs, great athletes.
It's approximately...
And how appropriate for the first breed to start us off, the king of dogs, the Afghan hound.
One of the oldest breeds.
King's hunting dogs in Afghanistan, but Pablo Picasso had an Afghan hound. In fact, his sculpture in Daly Plaza is said to be his dog.
Okay, straight down the back.
This is Anton, owner-handler, breeder-owner-handler, Karen Wagner from York, Pennsylvania.
This is a beauty. Look at this one. Look at this dog over here.
Anton's actually a half-brother of my famous dog, Zumi, from the late 80s.
This was your breed for many years, wasn't it?
It was indeed. And still is in my heart.
One of my favorites as well, the way this moves through the ring. Reminds me of the elegance and posture of a dancer.
Here's our first mention today of form and function. The Afghan's a sight hound. It's tall, leggy. It has a great outlook to be able to spot its prey and the great athletic ability to run it down.
Indeed, the two breeds have many things in common, speed being one of them.
Next up is the Whippet.
The Whippet was used as a rabbit for
us. Has a distinctive silhouette outline. Looks a bit like a miniature greyhound. The top line's quite different. But these are probably the greatest athletes in the dog show world. Can run about 35 or 40 miles an hour. They're not quite as fast, flat out, as the greyhound, perhaps. But cutting, running through an open field, it's unbelievable. This is brazen.
Very popular family pet as well.
It's a tough little dog in an elegant package, but they are intense hunters and can really run.
Good girl.
Beautiful markings here.
Thank you.
Lovely dog.
I see that very disciplined gait. Judging the hound group today is Mrs. Barbara Dempsey Alderman, assisted by Eric Dweer and Sam McDonald of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia. Here he is, the royal dog of Scotland. David?
This is Chelsea. They're kind of a rough-coated greyhound, are these Scottish deerhounds, and if they were smaller, there'd be a lot more of them around, but they are gentle, sweet, love children. But they were originally bred to hunt antlered game in Scotland.
I also read a note that they could pull a man off a horse. They used them for military reasons as well.
Well, they're big athletic dogs. Most perfect creature in heaven, wrote Walter Scott. This is Chelsea, who's a daughter of Hickory, the famous Westminster Best in Show winner from 2011. Handled by Angela Lloyd. From Flint Hill, Virginia.
Nice bounce to the gate there.
It's supposed to be an easy, active gate.
Just a reminder, we're not able to show you the walk-in examinations of every dog in the hound group, but if you go online to nationaldogshow.com, you can watch every breed winner in our Best in Breed online video special that includes the expert commentary of Wayne Ferguson from the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
And here's the state dog of Virginia, the American Foxhound.
Truly American dog, isn't it?
It certainly is. George Washington was one of the early fanciers of this breed. Remember the great Best in Show dog, Jewel, the American Foxhound Best in Show here a couple of years ago.
Years back, indeed. Yeah.
Same owner and breeders on this one, Ellen Charles and Lisa Miller. Lisa Miller, the breeder and handler here.
Okay, right around. Thank you.
Washington, D.C.
Owning a pack of foxhounds, very much a sign of social status many years ago.
The dogs, they have to have a docile temperament because they have to get along with everybody in that pack.
Good.
It's a beautiful blue tick coon hound.
Raccoon hunter, bred for that.
Good dog. Okay,
their standard says they should be a free tonguer on trail with a medium bawl or bugle voice. That's great on the trail. It's great in the field. But think about it if you live in a neighborhood. If you've got neighbors that you want to keep happy.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, some of the hounds are actually good watchdogs. Some are not. The deerhound that we saw before, not a good watchdog. This one, a very good one.
This is Jedi. Jedi does coon hunting on his off time. Also has a CGC title from the AKC, Canine Good Citizen from Solomons, Maryland. With owner Kendall Steffer.
The Bloodhound is an ancient breed, tracking back 2,500 years at least.
And the most distinctive of the scent hounds. Unstoppable when it's on a scent trail, isn't it? The Bloodhound.
You can see all the skin and the folds and the ears that help it gather the scent. This is Mongo, who is actually a nephew of Nathan, our Best in Show winner from last year.
Good boy. Over and back.
Wonderful dogs, but very scent-driven. And we like to say that the body really is only a mode of transportation for the nose, because it's the nose that gets this dog going. But they are a high-energy, strong dog. They might be a little drooly, so you have to know what you're getting into if you're going to get into this dog. If you're a neat freak, this might not be the dog for you.
This was the breed of our Best in Show winner last year.
The dog is from St. Joseph, Illinois. As we see our judge there, Mrs. Alderman, going down the line, kind of collecting her thoughts.
The Afghan out here.
Making her cuts.
Ethan.
Ask for the Afghan. The Ibethan, the Whippet.
Foxhound.
Scottish Deerhound. American Foxhound.
You. The Bloodhound.
Maybe JB. There it is, a Bloodhound on Best in Show. It has made the cut this year.
As we say in our world, she's got a very nice, good pile here from her cuts. Makes the group look very good, very strong.
A favorite here?
Well, I like the Afghan Hound. I like the Deerhound, of course. He reminds me a lot of her mother.
I agree with you on the Afghan.
What a nice group. Looks like she's putting them in some kind of order here. I'm not sure she's quite done. And in fact, she is going to take them around one more time. There we go. But I think this is the way it's going to end up, John.
Deerhound is number one.
And indeed it is. There's your winner. Our first group, the Hound group, Scottish Deerhound.
American Foxhound is second, the Whippet is third, and the Bloodhound is fourth.
Indeed. Let's head backstage right now for a little more of the fashion, the fun, and the frolic. Johnny Weir and Tara Lipinski are there.
We are so excited to be backstage at our first national dog show. The drama.
The barking.
The quaffing.
The gossip.
And of course, our new best friends, the Standard Poodle.
And our buddy, the Border Collie. And we're not just learning about these show dogs. In a little bit, we visit with one of the most famous dogs of stage and screen.
And for more behind-the-scenes gossip and dish and videos and poofing, visit nationaldogshow.com.
And now with more of this year's new additions, we toss to Mary Carrillo. Mary?
Tara and Johnny, there are 7 new breeds this year. That is a modern record. Let's get right to them. All right, first, the Bergamasco from the herding group. There they are. The Berger Picard, also from the herding group. The Cherneco del Etna, the hound group. The Borbal, the working dog. That's a lot of dog. The Legato Romagnolo from the sporting group. The Spanish water dog, hola. The miniature American Shepherd. All right, 4 of the 7 have to go into the herding right now. It's just about to start. John and David, back to you. Welcome to the show, everybody.
Mary did a wonderful job pronouncing those names, David.
Here we are in the herding group, the German Shepherd Dog, the Belgian Malinois, the Belgian Sheepdog, and the Belgian Tervuren. Here's the Briard. Here's the Berger Picard, one of our new breeds. The Pyrenean Shepherd. Looking around, the Rough Collie, the Smooth Collie, the Shetland Sheepdog, the Australian Shepherd, the miniature American Shepherd, the Border Collie, the Bearded Collie. It's the Old English Sheepdog, the Polish Lowland Sheepdog, the Poolie, the Canine Dog, the Australian Cattle Dog, the Bouvier de Flandre, the Beauceron, the Bergamasco, another new breed, the Norwegian Boohund, the Icelandic Sheepdog, the Spanish Water Dog, another new breed, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, and the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. Our herding group, 30 breeds in the herding group. They are bred, of course, to be herding animals, to move livestock from one place to another. Athletic, tough little dogs might get kicked by a cow every now and then, but they'll go all day. High energy, great athletes.
Used for many years as a shepherd in both the north and south of France.
Here's the Briard to kick it off.
To guard small farms, to herd
working dog in France.
Your win? Yeah.
great protector of property and livestock. Thomas Jefferson's dog.
Very nice. You can see the distinctive breed traits here with those eyebrows that arch up, the beard, slightly wavy coat, and that little crook in the end of the tail. It's called a crochet. This is Izzy, a Best in Show winner from Cleveland, Ohio. Eugenia Kiner handling.
Judging the herding group is Mrs. Suli Greendale Pavisa, assisted by Mike Halstead and Harry Booker of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
Judges not only have to know the standard that describes the ideal specimen of the breed, they need to be able to envision this dog performing its function in the field.
And folks, welcome the...
Another of our four new breeds in the herding group, this is the Berger Picard. And those of you who saw the movie Because of Winn-Dixie, you're already a little bit familiar with this breed.
Berger means shepherd. Picard or Picardie was the region between Paris and Normandy.
We were a little concerned during the war years that this breed was going to become extinct. But the followers of this breed kept it going. It's kind of the clown prince of the herding dogs. Berger Picard. This dog is named only because it was the only girl in the litter.
Thank you, Miss.
One that's national specialty this year.
Yeah, it's a good-looking dog. Also, in addition to that one movie, it was also in... Daniel and the Super Dogs, and Are We There Yet? Three movies under the belt for this breed.
The Australian Shepherd. We've had an Australian Shepherd go Best in Show here at the National Dog Show, presented by Purina in the past. These dogs really aren't Australian. They were really developed exclusively in this country. They're called the Australian Shepherd because they have an association with the Basque Shepherds who came into the U.S. from Australia and developed the breed here. Beautiful dog. Eyes can come in a variety of colors, as is the coat. This is Ember, Jessica Plord handling. Some of three bests.
Thank you, Miss. All the way around, please.
This group, the herding group, make wonderful family pets, but do remember, they have the instinct to herd sheep, and they will herd your children as well.
Ember's about to retire to motherhood and also get involved with duck diving.
Collie or Beardy is an old Scottish breed that achieved recognition in the United States only...
Here's a popular one.
Congratulations on your win.
Bearded Collie. Silky coat. Energetic. Very affectionate.
We had a Bearded Collie go best here one year. This is Zach.
Jeremy. Okay, down a bit. Halfway.
Hairy, bright, and independent is the way they like to be described.
This breed is known for its double coat. David, can you explain what that means? Because it actually makes it waterproof.
Well, they have an inner coat that's shorter and denser, and then this outer coat that is part of protection from the elements, but also protection from the predators that they may cross paths with every now and then. These dogs need a lot of grooming.
Thank you, Miss, all the way around.
A lot
please.
Of exercise. There's the beardy bounce for you. As it's calm.
This dog loves it. Listen.
A lot of the crowd say, you know, my dog jumps up on me, too. How come I'm glad I'm not the only one with that going on in my world. Katie Shepherd handling Zach. This is the Beauceron. Relatively new breed. The largest of the French hunting breeds. A very well-muscled dog. They really kind of refer to them as a living fence for their tribute to their work.
Halfway down and back, please.
This is a big dog, and if you're looking for a great companion dog because you are a runner or a cycler, this is your animal right there.
This is Gideon. He's 7 years old. He's the top-winning Beauceron in AKC history, handled by Tony Carter from Seattle, Washington. Gideon was a search and rescue dog for the Klamath County, Oregon Sheriff's Department.
Thank you, sir, all the way around, please.
Retired, became a show dog. Seven all breed bests.
This is a sheepdog with a very strong work.
And here is another of our new breeds, the Bergamasco Sheepdog.
All of the characteristics of a herder, very strong, very agile. This breed just comes with a set of curtains.
This is Pandia. She's 8 years old. She's also a therapy dog and visits monthly to her owner's class of special needs kids in Philadelphia. Atta girl, Pandia.
You'll see the mats there. formed by three different types of hair. They hit the ground by about the age of six, apparently.
You know, you saw all the new breed dogs out there gathered with Mary. One of those dogs in each breed advances into the group, and they all want to be a part of today, being their first shot on national TV. So they're all here to support one another and have fun being part of the National Dog Show presented by Purina.
That coat, of course, a wonderful bit of camouflage for the elements. A stealth protector of the herd.
And here's the Norwegian Boo Hund. Norwegian word Boo means homestead or farm, and Hund means dog. And that's our talented young handler, Emma Rogers. We saw her last year with the American Foxhound in the group.
Great to see some of the young people being handlers now. She's quite good, David.
She is quite good. Her identical twin, Faith, is also a very talented young handler as well. And their older sister, Sophia. Great family sport, the sport of dogs. Junior showmanship for the kids. Time together for the families. There's Emma with Gibbs, who's only 11 months old. Already won six group placements from Wrightstown, New Jersey.
There's a hand of approval from Emma's mom. Mary Carrillo had a chance to spend some time with the family backstage. More of that later, that conversation.
Now she's making her cuts. Our judges had her hands on all the dogs, and now she's putting everything together. What she felt, what she saw.
The Beardy, please.
Beardy makes the cut.
Have the Pooley, please.
It's the Bergère. She brings out the Bergère.
Very good for the new breeds. Emma makes the cut.
I think she's done.
Thank you very much for a lovely group, folks.
Is it?
The Beardy will be
it
number one.
It is indeed.
One.
Herding group. The bearded collie wins.
The Australian Shepherd will be number two.
The Beardy Collie.
The Briard will be number three. And young lady, you will be number four.
Emma takes fourth, and her mama's happy.
The Australian Shepherd was second. The Briard was third. And the Norwegian Bull Hund with Emma was fourth.
Two down on our way to Best in Show. Why does a dog have a tail? To a dog, a tail is a wonderful thing, because it adds to their shape, whether fluffy or thin, and tails can be fun. When there's nothing to do, you just turn in a circle and try to tail chew. But here's the reason. The dogs need a tail, even though it's a curious part. Don't look where it ends, but look where it starts. For all dogs need a tail to attach to their hearts.
Your dog has unique traits. Is your dog food designed to address them? The experts at Purina Pro Plan have made it easy to find a food that will. Introducing My Plan. Tell us about your dog's traits and preferences, and we'll recommend a perfect fit. My Plan considers factors like your dog's age, activity level, stool quality, and body condition, to name a few. You'll get our expert recommendation, plus tips you can put to work right away. You've seen how it works. Now create a plan for your dog. My Plan, from the experts at Purina Pro Plan. Create your plan today and get a valuable offer.
Life ensures that when things can't possibly get worse, they always do. Life needs Ziploc.
S.C. Johnson.
I'm ready.
Intel's best processor is here. So you can take this very real, very terrifying memory and edit it, share it, play it back in 4K quality.
Introducing Intel's new 6th generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
What if the holidays were about people again? And the four-letter word that defined the season was L-O-V-E, and not S-A-L-E. That's the world TJ Maxx, Marshalls, and HomeGoods stores live in. Where there's no need for sales, because we offer amazing prices on thoughtful gifts every day. Let's put more value on what really matters. This season, bring back the holidays with TJ Maxx, Marshalls, and HomeGoods.
Hey guys, Bridget Mendler from Undateable Live. Check out a new episode of our show next Friday, but for now, enjoy the National Dog Show. Mo, who do you think is going to take it this year? Well, yeah, the standard poodle is difficult to beat. Whoa, no cursing on television. Sorry, he's jealous.
Hello, everyone. Happy Thanksgiving. John O'Hurley here with my co-host, David Frei. Overflow crowds and also an overflow of competitors this year. 1,800 dogs are competing for best in show. They're trying to do with this dog. Our special guest here did last year. David, reintroduce us.
Well, here's Nathan, the wonderful bloodhound that was best in show here last year at the National Dog Show. Yes, I love you, too. Nathan retired last year with 37 all-breed best in shows, which is pretty darn good.
Well, I envy every moment of that. We have a lot more excitement, including our seven new breeds that we'll be introducing today. Let's get back to the judging. I don't think he's quite finished with you.
He's going to call me later. The working group. Here they are, the lunch bucket dogs. Their uses vary. They were bred to do things for man, to do some work for us, whether it's guard the homes or be working farm animals, draft animals, police dogs, military dogs, security animals. Most of them are big and powerfully built. They're all very intelligent. And here's our lineup. Here's the Doberman Pinscher. Here's the Black Russian Terrier, the Giant Schnauzer, the Standard Schnauzer, the Rottweiler, the Bernese Mountain Dog, the Greater Swiss Mountain Dog, the Siberian Husky, the Samoyed, the Akita, the Boxer, a very recognizable Great Dane, the Bull Mastiff, the Mastiff, the Tibetan Mastiff, the Neapolitan Mastiff, Fang, hi Fang, the Cane Corso, the Dog de Bordeaux, is our new breed, the Borbol, the Portuguese Water Dog, the Newfoundland, the Leonberger, the St. Bernard, the Great Pyrenees, and the Commodore. Our Steadicam is kind of at a different level across this group. They're all big dogs.
Very recognizable profile of the Doberman.
It's an elegant athlete in a tight-fitting wrapper is the way they've always described this breed to me, and I love that. One of the few breeds that was bred to protect man, actually. Mr. Doberman, who developed the breed, was a tax collector.
Show me the bite.
So he needed a little protection. Also great war heroes. The dog,
thank you.
The War Dog Cemetery in Guam has a statue, Always Faithful, by Susan Bahari. And the dog is also at Quantico Marine Corps Research Center.
Down and back as far as...
This is Luca.
Some may recall back in the 70s a trio of movies called the Doberman Gang, where they were trained to rob banks. They were working both sides of the fence, the tax collector's side and the... But they're also part of the police ranks as well, in addition to the military. But, you know, oddly enough, these are very good family dogs, David, if they're properly trained.
Well, that's true of just about any breed, especially the large ones that need to know who's in charge and what you want them to do. This dog is actually a trained medical alert dog,
thank
which
you,
means he'll alert on his partner, his human partner, if they're facing maybe a seizure alert from diabetes or a heart situation or something like that, and alert them that it's time to take their medications. Here's the Rottweiler, the middle linebacker of dogs.
Please. Judging the working group today is Mrs. Debbie Wilkins, assisted by Dave Helming and Steve Sansone of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
The Rottweiler is another of those dogs that appreciates the master that is in control. They'll do anything for you.
When you're ready, down and back, please.
They want to be with you, so you just need to make sure that they understand the rules there. Maverick's a therapy dog, actually. Goes to nursing homes, visits a nursery school where he teaches children about safety around dogs. Carissa Champagno is the handler here. Her mother just handled the Doberman. Great family sport, the sport of showing dogs, the sport of dogs, any kind of competition. Junior showmanship for the kids, agility, other performance events. Go to akc.org and find out all the great things that your dog can do through AKC activities. Both purebred dogs and non-purebred dogs, the All-American dogs, are part of that as well.
Here's the Samoyed. Beautiful coat.
Samoyed, originally their job was to herd the reindeer and work as a sledding team. And talking about tails, John, They have a curled tail that covers their nose while they sleep. That supposedly helps to warm the inhaled air up there in the Arctic. This is actually Bogey, who was our reserve Best in Show winner last year with Andrew Green Handling, Flemington, New Jersey. There's a little something about our names. Pebbles Run, Play It Again, Ham is the registered name, so its calling is, of course, Bogey. See that Sammy Ed smile. They're supposed to have a black pigment.
And all the way around, please.
It should be pure white or cream color.
And we'll come back with more of the working group right after this.
This Saturday at Kohl's, take an extra 20% off with your savings pass. Use it in store and online. And get sleepwear and loungewear for just $7.99 each. For men and women, for girls and boys, for everyone in the family. Saturday only. Plus, only once a year, get $15 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. Use your extra 20% off savings pass this Saturday when you shop Kohl's and Kohl's.com.
Now earn 10% cash back at Amazon with Chase Freedom through December. Chase Freedom, the card is for the essentials. The cash back is for the fun. Learn more at chase.com/freedom. Chase, so you can.
An all-star cast, The Wiz Live, Thursday on NBC.
Teamwork, over 35 years experience. At Searcy Denny, we have an experienced team to pursue justice.
At Searcy Denny, we pursue justice. If you're a victim of an auto or trucking accident, learn more at CircyLaw.com.
Now only Ford offers $750 Black Friday bonus cash on select vehicles on top of Ford Friends and Neighbors pricing.
That doesn't happen every day.
Make Black Friday hassle-free with low prices on Ford cars, trucks, and SUVs. And get $750 Black Friday bonus cash on select Ford vehicles on top of all other offers.
It's an inside deal.
Now for everyone.
Hurry, for a limited time, get $750 Black Friday bonus cash on select vehicles on top of all other low Ford Friends and Neighbors offers. It all ends November 30th.
Stories that matter to you. Weeknights on WPTV News Channel 5.
Cloud 9 Superstore, where you can shop.
Look at that. Looks like he fell asleep shopping.
He's not.
Till you drop.
Oh! What's going to happen to the couch?
Does that mean it's going to be on sale?
Superstore. Special preview Monday, 10, 9 Central after The Voice on NBC.
Thank you, Bailey, for teaching my daughter to love dogs.
Thank you, Zoe, for being my road trip partner.
Thank you, Finn, for keeping my kitchen floors spotless.
Bo, for making me spend more time outdoors.
Thank you, Louie, for keeping us safe from squirrels.
And the mailman.
For your unconditional love.
It's for being our son's best friend.
Thank you, Mongo.
Thank you, Choco.
Thank you, Choco.
Thank you, Bentley.
Casey.
Raspberry.
Bruno. Zoa.
This Thanksgiving, Purina wants to thank our four-legged friends who help make our lives so special. For every original post, tweet, and shout-out, Purina's going to donate $1 to the AKC Canine Health Foundation. So upload a photo or a video and use the hashtag DogThanking. And make sure that Purina sees it by adding the @Purina right at the end. Purina, your pet, our passion. Don't forget your dog thanking today as we continue with the working group. Here is the Bull Mastiff, David.
The Bull Mastiff is the gamekeeper's night dog. If you run down the road a little bit here, you'll see the 600-pound statue at Fairmont Park in Philadelphia featuring a Bull Mastiff. There's the IRS stare that we talk about. The Bull Mastiffs still embody the tenacity of the very first bulldogs and the strength of those ancient Mastiff breeds.
You know, we talk about this group in particular. They were bred to pull carts and really work the farm. And it's, you know, interesting to note that dogs weren't pets back then. Dogs had functions back then. And we celebrate that today.
Now they're members of our family.
Indeed.
They don't pull carts. They don't need to go hunting so much. We got grocery stores. We got electronic surveillance for our security. Now they're members of our family. This is Soleil from Wallingford, Connecticut. And here's the Newfoundland.
I'll be seeing a few of these shortly, actually, just beginning my role as Captain Hook in Peter Pan. We have, of course, Nana is a Newfoundland in that show, and I'll be introduced to two of them very shortly.
Well, the basic rule for Newfoundlanders is that when you're dressed up in your good clothes, get out the door fast. This is not a dog for neat freaks. They love to play in their water, usually take it directly to you from the water dish.
Apply it topically.
That's right. Well, talking about you in the theater with the Newfoundlands, we saw a great show, Sylvia, on Broadway, that's about a man who finds a stray dog in Central Park, brings it home. He loves it. His wife's not crazed about it, but it leads him on a wonderful journey. It's a great show. We love the starring Matthew Broderick and Annalee Ashford. Did a nice charity benefit for Angel on a Leash, our therapy dog charity.
Pretty Newfoundland.
Here's Winslow, 4-year-old male, Michael Scott Handling. Won a lot of titles in the Newfoundland world from Alexandria, Virginia.
This is one of the largest in the Hungarian.
Well, we know what this is attached to. This is the Commodore. This is a large Commodore. I think in all the years we've been together, this may be the largest I've seen, David.
Well, Chauncey's 6 years old. He's been growing a lot of coat. 6 and a half now, actually.
Thank you.
Heather Helmer, Nathan's handler, okay, is there. Chauncey was a star on NBC Nightly News with Lester Holt back at the time of Superstorm Sandy, when NBC came out and did a story about how the storm affected Chauncey and his family, the Wilcheskis from Wall Township, New Jersey. Those cords are something else, but they are a working dog. They're not a herding dog. They protect the flocks. They don't move them. These cords, something else. I still remember the very first time you saw one on our first show. You said something about the dog being the first purchase you should make if you own a car wash.
That's exactly right. Well, as you can imagine, out in the field, there's nothing more dangerous than having a car wash out there. Side to side. Oddly enough, not as much maintenance as one would think.
You kind of have to start those cords on their way to forming, but after that, just stay out of the way.
That direction, please. And the Black Russian.
Picking her cut right now. Doberman out there.
Hear her making her picks. Nice dogs. Nice group.
The Bull Mastiff, please. The Neapolitan Mastiff, please. The Portuguese Water Dog.
Oh, the Neo was out there, too.
All the Harry Potter fans are rooting for Fang here, right?
That's a beauty. Beautiful coat, that silver gray that he has.
It's a Portuguese Water Dog there. It's the Black Russian Terrier.
The Newfie is Group 1, please.
Newfoundland is your winner, picked right out.
The Samoyed is Group 2, please. The Doberman, 3. And the Bull Mastiff is 4.
You probably heard her pick. Second is the Samoyed, third is the Doberman, and fourth is the Bull Mastiff.
And there is our winner. The third group, the Newfoundland, on our way to Best in Show. And as we thank the dogs in our life, we want to thank them also for being our most loyal viewers, as we salute the dogs across America who watch all with one thought in mind: I could have been a contender.
Kellogg's Frosted Mini Wheats have 8 layers of nutritious wheat and 1 of delicious sweet to satisfy the adult and kid in all of us. Nutritious wheat for the adult you've grown into, and delicious sweet for the kid you'll never outgrow. Feed your inner kidult with Frosted Mini Wheats.
So why do they call it Black Friday anyway?
I don't know, but I think they should call it Pink Friday.
Oh, boy.
I mean, have glitter.
Black Friday continues now through Saturday with tons of awesome deals. Toys R Us, a whole store of awesome. Get 50% off Barbie Rockin' Royals limo.
Tis the season to save big at Lowe's. So hurry into your neighborhood store today for great Black Friday deals on all things Christmas. Now get these Holiday Living 100-count Christmas lights for only $1.99.
The secret then? Baking soda. Now, the 2-in-1 cleaning power of Arm & Hammer plus OxiClean Power Packs. A powerful combination of baking soda plus OxiClean stain-fighting crystals for a whiter, brighter clean. And save up to 50%. Arm & Hammer Power Packs. Big clean, small price.
The cold truth is, you can't work from home when you're sick. You need real relief. Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Cold and Flu has 3 cold symptom fighters to relieve your tough symptoms. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
I'm watching that.
Ew.
Every Christmas is memorable. But a gift from Kay Jewelers makes it unforgettable. Because it's more than a gift. It's a memory she'll wear forever. Save 25% on any Citizen watch. Powered by light. Any light never needs a battery. At Kay, the number one memory maker in America.
Every kiss begins with K.
Thursday, it's the live event of the season. Mary J. Blige, Common, Neil, David Allen Greer, Elijah Kelly, Shanice Williams, Amber Riley, Stephanie Mills, Uzo Aduba, and Queen Latifah.
I'm the all-powerful Wizard of Oz.
The Wiz, live, Thursday, 8, 7 Central on NBC.
Oh, my gosh. Hi. Now, Tara, this is a Cairn Terrier.
Yeah, Johnny, who does he remind me of? Johnny, I don't think we're in Philly anymore.
It actually looks a lot like Kansas.
Oh, my gosh, are you Dorothy?
Well, no, I'm Shanice Williams, but I'm playing Dorothy. Yeah. Johnny, she's the star of The Wiz live on NBC. Tell me what it's like in your mind right now, knowing that you have to step out on the stage in front of a live audience. What's the pressure like? So many emotions going on in my head, but I'm just super excited, and we have a great cast.
Now, the most important member of that cast is Toto. Yeah. Have you bonded?
He is so sweet and so cute, but actually, I can't find him.
Really?
Yeah, well, I gotta go. So if you see my dog Toto, let me know.
We're on it.
Come on, buddy. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Johnny, is that Toto?
Is that Toto?
Wow. Oh, hi, Toto.
How are you? Hi.
Hi, Toto.
So this is Toto, right?
This is Scooter. He plays Toto.
Hi, Scooter.
Hi, Scooter. You just rescued him in July.
Yep.
So this is all very new for him. Is he a quick learner?
He's a quick learner, and he has an understudy. His brother is his understudy.
So all in the family.
So, guys, I got to get back to rehearsal. Nice to meet you both.
Nice to meet you, too. Break a leg, Toto.
Break a leg.
Thanks.
Oh, gosh, Tara, we have to get back to the show.
Well, I mean, you know what we have to do. Go ahead, click them.
Welcome back to the Greater Philadelphia Expo Center. Time now for the Terrier Group, presented by Petco.
The Terriers. From the Latin word terra, meaning going to ground after their quarry, some of us will jokingly say, jokingly of course, that is short for terrors, because they are on their feet looking for trouble all the time, for varmints and pests, trying to keep our world safe. Great stamina, determination, and courage. Different kinds of coats on all of them.
There's
a lovely group in here. They are. There's the Airedale. There's the Irish Terrier. The Welsh Terrier. The Lakeland Terrier. There's the Smooth Fox Terrier. The Parson Russell Terrier. The Russell Terrier. The Border Terrier. The Kerry Blue. The Soft-Coated Wheaton. The Bedlington Terrier. The Rat Terrier. The Miniature Schnauzer. The Australian Terrier. The Cairn Terrier. The Scottish Terrier. The Sealyham Terrier. The Chesky Terrier. Here's the West Highland White Terrier, the Skye Terrier, the Glen of Amal Terrier, the American Staffordshire Terrier, the White Bull Terrier, the Colored Bull Terrier, the Staffordshire Bull Terrier, the Miniature Bull Terrier, and the Norwich Terrier. 31 breeds in the terrier group.
Yeah, so you're getting an awe factor there. What a great little punctuation point he was. All right, let's begin with the Smooth Fox Terrier. David?
Well, the Smooth Fox Terrier and the Wire Fox Terrier were once considered to be one breed in two different varieties until about 1984. Lots of coat, even though you can't tell there. They have lots of coat, needs a lot of constant work. Here's Bradley, a best-in-show Smooth Fox Terrier.
It's that wonderful marking, that black patch over the right eye.
North Collins, New York, with breeder, owner, handler, Dana Gable. We like the breeder, owner, handlers. They're the ones that do it all. They've bred this dog. It was born in their home.
Judging this group, Mr. Bobby Pounce, assisted by Peter Green and Harry Booker of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
Well, here's Bradley, a three-year-old male. Actually won the group here last year. Athletic little dogs.
Thank you.
High energy.
They do. They keep up with the hounds all day on the fox hunts and things. Travel in the saddlebags. And then hit the ground and help find the quarry. Who doesn't love a terrier?
Very popular group.
The miniature schnauzer here. The most common color is salt and pepper, but now we're seeing a lot of blacks like this. Square dog. Great, great family dog. They don't shed. Good in the house. But they started out as a multi-purpose farm dog in Germany.
To about the four and back.
This is Valentine, a three-year-old female. Breeder, owner, handler again, Sean Immler.
Good example there of the tail becoming a handle as well. That's what they were bred to do.
Well, those tails help keep them out of trouble. You know, if they go into a burrow and they're face-to-face with something disagreeable, that's something for the handler to grab and get them out of trouble. It's a strong appendage. That's not true in every breed. Now, don't be doing it on your other dogs, but with terriers, it's helpful.
And there it is. Our crowds are unrestrained. Team Schnauzer. And when we come back, more of the ever-popular Terrier group after this.
This is the time for harmony. Let love be the song that everybody sings. Fill the air with joyful noise. Ring the bells and raise your voice. Let there be peace on earth. Let there be peace on earth.
JCPenney's Black Friday sale starts Thursday at 3 p.m. Hurry in to get your special invitation code for a chance to win one of 10 $10,000 cash grand prizes in our $100,000 Black Friday sweepstakes while supplies last. JCPenney, where giving begins.
It's time to play Game Time Gold at McDonald's.
How about them Cowboys?
Get a Chicken McNuggets 20-piece for $5, and you'll get two chances to win. With millions of instant win prizes and a $500,000 winner guaranteed every week, who's your team?
So why do they call it Black Friday anyway?
I don't know, but I think they should call it Pink Friday.
Oh, boy.
And we could have glitter.
Black Friday continues now through Saturday with tons of awesome deals. Toys R Us, a whole store of awesome. Get our favorite family board games, just $5 each.
Lisa!
Took you so long.
Duracell Quantum lasts longer in 99% of devices, so you can power imagination all day long.
Not getting your best sleep? Could be you've got the wrong bed. Enter Sleep Number. She likes the bed soft. He's more hardcore. You can both adjust the bed for the best sleep of your life. Only at a Sleep Number store. Save 50% on the Ultimate Limited Edition bed. Hurry, sale ends Monday. No better sleep with Sleep Number.
From the big gifts that mean a lot, to the little ones that mean everything. Get the perfect gift for everyone and share wonder on Christmas Day. Walmart.
The holidays don't officially begin until we light the tree. So join Carly Rae Jepsen, James Taylor, Mary J. Blige, Andrea Bocelli, Band of Merrymakers, Angie Grammer, Pentatonics, and more. It's Christmas in Rockefeller Center live, Wednesday on NBC.
Hide all your gifts. Protect your holiday tree. How the Grinch Stole Christmas is coming to NBC.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch.
He'll sneak and he'll steal every holiday delight, so don't miss his green, grinny face Wednesday night.
Welcome back to the National Dog Show, presented by Purina, a very popular breed right here, the Scottish Terrier, also the winner several times of Best in Show. This breed, very, very prolific.
That famous Sadie, we remember, won at the National Dog Show. They won the American Kennel Club National Championship, and they won at Westminster. That was Sadie, the great Scotty, who won here a few years ago.
Here's a great-looking one, too, huh?
Beautiful dog. This is Sophie.
Down to about the fore and back, please.
I love the Scotty people who tell me they are not big listeners. It's probably true of a lot of Scotties. But they have this great coat that we were talking about earlier in another breed, but it's a dense undercoat and a wiry outer coat for protection. They're dealing with some disagreeables every once in a while themselves. It's one of the oldest terriers, the Scotty.
Circle right around to the end.
Sophie is a multiple Best in Show dog winner. Ernesto Lara handling. We've seen Ernesto on Best in Show dogs here in the past. Most recent being Banana Joe from Miami, Florida. Sophie.
Now, here's a beauty. Look at this Sky Terrier.
Love the way these ears, you know, we talk about breed traits that really make a breed, an individual breed. Those ears, that long and low and level setting.
Kind of like a coat hanger.
Isn't that great coat? Look at those ears.
This is a beauty, huh?
And I also love the fact that we talk about these dogs. They're big dogs. They just have short legs. And that's true of the Sky, too, because they are a feisty, fun-loving, hardworking dog. This is Charlie. Charlie has 78 Best in Shows. He's the number one terrier, number one Sky in the country the last 2 years.
Really beautiful, yeah.
Best in Show at the AKC National Championship last year, and reserve Best in Show right at the Westminster Kennel Club in 2015. Larry Cornelius handling.
Another popular handler there, too. You watch him moving the dog at the speed that they should.
It's so important for the handlers to become invisible out there and let the dog show themselves.
This is the American Staffordshire Terrier.
Number one AM staff in the country the last 3 years and has won the breed 4 years in a row here at the National Dog Show. And that's appropriate. It's a dog from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Belongs to Evelyn Heath, who's a Philadelphia police officer. Co-owns with Dave Barry. This is Chris Berg, the handler, with Flash. AMP staffs are courageous, intelligent, affectionate, all of those things. And to be in the hands of good people, and they're great dogs. No bad dogs, only bad owners.
Thank you, sir. Round to the end, please.
These were war heroes carrying messages in World War II.
It's a good-looking dog, isn't it?
It's a beautiful dog. This is Flash. Well, nice group. As always, the Terry group is always very competitive.
Calling out his cut right now.
Welsh.
Brings the Airedale out.
Jack Russell, please.
Is that the Welsh and the Lakeland, I think. There you go.
Sir.
Scotty makes it.
It's a tough
Sky
group.
Terrier.
It's a tough group to make a cut when you have so many good ones. We've got to get down to business.
Thank you all. The Sky Terrier is first.
And the Sky Terrier.
The Scotty is second.
Is your winner.
The Smooth is third. And the Amstaff is fourth.
You heard his announcements. The Scottish Terrier is second. The Smooth Fox Terrier is third. And the Amstaff, the American Staffordshire Terrier, is fourth.
And we're now more than halfway there to Best in Show. The Sky Terrier is our winner here. And next up, small in size, big in heart, with love that knows no bounds, they are anxiously awaiting their turn to remind us all that precious gifts come in small packages.
Starting Black Friday, the Pandora Holiday Charm gift set is waiting for you, only at Jared. With 12 holiday-themed Pandora charms and clips, featuring the Jared-exclusive Prancing Reindeer charm and a very special limited edition charm, all in this beautiful Pandora keepsake box. And right now, you'll save $220 on this amazing Jared-exclusive. For that one special Pandora gift, there's only one special place to go, Jared.
So why do they call it Black Friday anyway?
I don't know, but I think they should call it Pink Friday.
Oh, boy.
We have glitter.
Black Friday continues now through Saturday with tons of awesome deals. Toys R Us, a whole store of awesome. Get our favorite family board games, just $5 each.
Big news. Switch to Sprint and save 50% on Verizon, AT&T, or T-Mobile rates. It's the biggest offer in U.S. wireless history. Plus, Thanksgiving Day through Cyber Monday, lease a Samsung Galaxy S6 for half price. Only $9 a month. So switch today.
An all-star cast. The Wiz live Thursday on NBC.
This is my new mattress from Haverty's. I'm waking up so refreshed now. I used to be a bit groggy in the morning. Those were dark days.
Wake up refreshed on a mattress from Haverty's. Save up to $300 instantly on a Tempur-Breeze mattress. Plus, enjoy 60-month no-interest financing. Haverty's. Discover something new.
The perfect car calls for the perfect price, and Lexus of Palm Beach has it. During the Lexus December to Remember sales event, lease a new 2016 Lexus ES350 or new RX350. Your choice, only $300 a month. Plus, Friday through Sunday only, get an HD TV with any new Lexus. Only at Lexus of Palm Beach, an AutoNation company and proud supporter of the AutoNation Cure Bowl. Visit LexusofPalmBeach.com.
Time is running out. The amazing Rooms to Go holiday sale ends Monday at 9 p.m. Save on the furniture you want and get 60-month interest-free financing. 60. That's 5 years from now. Get incredible prices on the sophisticated Sofia Vergara collection, the latest from Cindy Crawford Home and iSofa. It's so easy and affordable. How can you resist? So hurry to the Rooms to Go holiday sale before it ends at 9 p.m. Monday.
Monday and Tuesday, it's down to the top 10.
How great to have this moment right now.
Giving you 10 reasons to vote. 10 reasons to instantly save an artist's dream.
We kind of got it all, actually.
The Voice, live Monday and Tuesday on NBC, and get the NBC app.
The Kennel Club of Philadelphia has a long and proud history dating back to the late 1800s. The National Dog Show is one of the oldest sporting events in America. The Kennel Club uses this and other contributions to support a variety of canine causes. There he is, our on-site announcer, Wayne Ferguson, president of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia. This year, our chief ring steward is Dr. Dwayne Butheris, and the permanent ring steward is Stanley Broadbent. The always popular crowd favorite, the toys, are here. David, take us down the line.
The little guys are just as important. There's the Italian Greyhound, the Chinese Crested, a Powderpuff, the Pomeranian, the Smooth Coat Chihuahua, the Long Coat Chihuahua, the Toy Fox Terrier, the Miniature Pinscher, the Havanese, the Maltese, the Shih Tzu, the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel, the two varieties of English Toy Spaniels, the Japanese Chin, Johnny Weir, that's for you. The Papillon, the Yorkshire Terrier, the Affin Pinscher, the Brussels Griffon, and the Pug. The toy dogs resemble their larger cousins that you see in some of the other groups. They're perfect for city dwellers. Small companions, great portability. They can go anywhere with you, which is what we all want. There's a study in the United Kingdom that actually says people with toy dogs are more agreeable, John.
Understand that. These dogs are known for their personality. Let's begin with personality right there. Look at that.
This is the Smooth Chihuahua. It actually is a fearless dog. They really think they're a big dog, like so many of these toy dogs. They think they're a big dog in a small package, but so that makes them a bit of a first-class watchdog in a lot of ways. Very alert and terrier-like are the Chihuahuas. This is Sonito, who's actually the top-winning Chihuahua of all time. At just 3 years of age, he's already won 45 Best in Show, won their national specialty twice. Great little show dog.
An example of a good handler there. The way that lead is being held, so that dog is moving at the proper speed.
It's a great little show dog. Sonito is actually bilingual because he was raised in Mexico City. But he's a native of the country where the breed originates.
Around the ring, I'm behind.
I see the alertness right there. That was a little extra for the judge.
I love it when they do things like that. It gets the crowd.
Yeah, listen to the crowd, sure. I could do other stuff, too.
Here's Johnny Weir's breed, the Japanese Chin. Johnny loves his chin. He was telling me all about him. Just like anybody else, he pulls out his cell phone and shows me pictures of his dog. So,
that's a great little pushed-in face that looks like the cigar just blew up.
Well, the standard says they need a distinctive Oriental expression. And they are little gremlins. This dog is named Precious, of course.
Judging the toy group is Mr. Espen Eng, assisted by Ron Scott, Peter Green of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
Angela Lloyd is handling Precious here.
Now one's straight up and back. Please only go
Japanese halfway. Chins were originally called Japanese Spaniels until about 1977. Some great little dogs. Angela Lloyd, all breed handler. It's a lot different than her handling the deer hound. Shows how versatile Angela is. These handlers have to know the breeds and know what's important.
Around the ring, I'm behind, please.
It's a showy little girl, Precious. Amesfield, Virginia.
Good afternoon.
Most popular toy dog, the Yorkshire Terrier. This is Kino.
All dressed up to show.
5 pounds of perfection. That coat.
Look at the eyes. You know, you ever wonder when you're looking in your dog's eyes what name they've selected for you?
See, there's the guy who knows how to open the refrigerator. Beautiful dog, Kino. 3 years old, multiple specialty show winner. Don Kelly, the handler.
That one's straight up and back.
These dogs were actually much bigger at one time, in the 10, 12-pound range. But they were bred to be this color of coal, so they wouldn't look dirty after a day in the mines with the miners in Yorkshire. It's blue and tan color. As our judge takes a look. They're the guardians of the lunch bags for the factory workers.
Then around the ring, I'm behind, please.
And as our Yorkie takes an elegant walk around the ring, we'll be back with more of the Terrier Group right after this.
Black Friday continues at JCPenney. Spend $25 or more and get $10 off with coupon. Kitchen electrics and some other exclusions apply. Plus, find amazing doorbusters starting 3 p.m. Friday and lasting all day Saturday. Get great deals like $9.99 sweaters for her, 60% off sweaters for him, or $9.99 kitchen electrics. JCPenney, where giving begins.
There are some people you should give underwear to this holiday. And there are some people you shouldn't. People you should. Shouldn't.
Janice!
Should. Shouldn't. Yes. No. Should. No way. Should. No. Definitely not.
Nah.
You shouldn't give underwear to everybody, but for those you do, give them Fruit of the Loom.
Arm & Hammer combines strength and beauty for true radiance. So for my radiant smile, I use Truly Radiant Rejuvenating Toothpaste. In just 5 days, it cleans, whitens, repairs, and strengthens enamel with a twist of mint. Be radiant with Truly Radiant.
It's easy to love your laxative when that lax loves your body back.
Only Miralax hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative, Miralax.
My name's Julian. I'm 5 years old. I live on an island, right here. My dad's in the Navy. I have a dog, but not like Abby's dog. Her dog is small. My dog is big. His name is Max. My mom likes to take pictures. I like to take pictures too. We like to send photos to my dad while he's at work.
He loves his dog, and it's part of his world, so whatever he's taking a picture, he incorporates him because he plays a huge role in his life. Pets tell a completely different story. We love them unconditionally, and they love us back.
Can I keep this one for the rest of my life?
Of course you can.
The Superstore. You've shopped there. Maybe you've even worked there.
Let's put our best foot forward, okay? And Sal, I'm gonna need you to take the creepiness down to about a 2.
From a producer of The Office comes a new comedy about life's unexpected moments.
An interesting tattoo. Is that a unicorn?
It's a horse with a railroad spike through his head.
I got
Superstore. Special preview Monday on NBC.
This Christmas, I would love to tell the true story from my childhood.
Thursday, December 10th.
Making me a baby blanket.
Making you a coat.
A new coat just for me.
Witness a true story of life's biggest struggles.
Every piece of that coat was sewn with love.
And how family and faith inspired a dream.
Love ain't just a feeling, it's an action. Love never fails.
Dolly Parton's Coat of Many Colors, Thursday, December 10th on NBC.
Sunday night is football night. We'll be in Denver for America's Game of the Week as Tom Brady and the Patriots take on the Broncos on Sunday Night Football. Coverage begins 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, only on NBC.
Good afternoon.
And we return now to the Affenpincher.
The name translated from German means monkey-like terrier. That mustache and beard and those eyebrows. Look at that look.
That's a sweet little face, huh?
The Diablotin Mustachu, which means mustached little devil. Tells you a little bit about his attitude.
Thank you.
We're a larger dog. They were a rat or more on the farm.
And they've halfway.
Kind of been bred down, and I think now it's more like a mouser in the house. This is Ben, who's just 6 months old. Can't be any younger than that and be in a dog show.
We want to remind you that we're not able to show you the walk and the examinations of every dog here in the toy group, but if you missed one of your favorite dogs, go online to nationaldogshow.com. You'll have the video and the expert commentary of all 180 breeds from today's National Dog Show presented by Purina.
Owner-handler Cynthia Lavaro, her husband is in Baghdad with the State Department, sent Ben a message today, wishing him good luck, but I know Ben is watching today from Baghdad.
And here's another cute little face, the Brussels Griffon.
This is Cayman, a national specialty winner. Jennifer Ellison handling from Chaplin, Connecticut, the Brussels. That Griffon in the name, the Brussels Griffon. Griffon means a lion-like appearance. Seen it with the wire-haired pointing Griffons as well. The Petit Passé Griffon, Vendéen. First of that face. Kind of a human appearance here.
Thank you.
But the expression of this dog really is the essence of the dog, of the breed type of the dog. It's got this great little attitude. We all remember, well, I hope all of us remember, the great movie As Good As It Gets that starred the Brussels Griffon and co-starred Jack Nicholson and Helen Hunt, who each won Oscars, but we really all know that the most important player was the dog.
It was pretty much about the dog last night.
So, here's Cayman. Standing there like a statue is our Judge Espen Eng, who's the past president of the Norwegian Kennel Club. He's from Lier, Norway.
Cuts a very dashing figure in the ring, doesn't he?
Does indeed.
Looks like he might be a conductor of a symphony.
And here's the pug and the pug mug.
final dog in the toy group. All these wrinkles in there give them this great look.
This has become one of my son's favorite breeds over the years of the show. He's only 8 years old, but he's come to love this breed particularly.
Thank you. And why not? They just are a great dog. They're the largest toy dog, and they're really in the toy group more for their attitude than they are for their size. Of course, from Holland, very popular in Holland. Actually, their roots are in China, but they made their name for themselves in Holland, where the pug saved the life of William, Prince of Orange, back in the 1500s. Made them the official dog of the House of Orange.
Thank you.
Here's Chez, the dog.
Then around the ring and behind pace.
It's very nice. Pugs always make me smile. With Barry Clothier, the handler. Loves the treadmill, he says about Chez. Hard to picture a pug on a treadmill.
Backstage here at the show, we have seen a few vendors that were selling dog treadmills, believe it or not. This is an interactive show, a bench show. Reminding you, as he's making his picks right now for his cuts, that it's quite an interactive experience for all the people here.
Lots of booths, lots of places to go. A bench dog show for the spectators who are here. They get a chance to walk around and see all the dogs up close and personal. Talk to the breeders and owners and handlers. Learn about dogs. Learn about the great purebred dogs and the things that they all stand for. And think about your own dog. It doesn't have to be a purebred dog. This is a celebration of the dogs in our lives.
Here is the cut that he's made. It's quite a good one.
It's a great group.
The winner is the smooth-coated Chihuahua.
No indecision there. There's your winner, the smooth coat Chihuahua. Happiest dog in the ring right now. Look at that. How'd I do? Oh, did I win?
Second goes to the Japanese Chin, third to the Brussels Griffon, and fourth to the Yorkshire Terrier.
And we have two groups left, to Best in Show and Backstage. Here we go. Bet your eyes. Turn around. Stand tall. Now back it up. 5, 10. I tell them who we are.
To do great things, sometimes you gotta break the rules. Surface Pro 4, a new screen for new perspectives. A new pen for new masterpieces. New speakers for a new sound. We reinvented the Surface Pro. 'Cause I wanna go fast. So you can reinvent everything else.
The cold truth is...
Okay, kids, let's go.
No one can really fill your shoes when you're sick. Alka-Seltzer Plus Hot Drink Mix has 4 cold symptom fighters to relieve your tough symptoms. Stay unstoppable. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
Here's a little healthy advice. Eat well. Live well.
Hi.
And take care of what makes you, you. Right down to your skin with Aveeno, Aveeno Daily Moisturizing Lotion with the goodness of active naturals oat and 5 vital nutrients for healthier looking skin in just one day. Healthy skin equals beautiful skin. And for shower softness, add the body wash too. Aveeno, naturally beautiful results.
Get ready.
3, 2, 1.
New Superstar Mascara by L'Oreal.
Superstar.
Super dramatic lashes. 1. Primer thickens to the max. Super volumized. 2. Black fiber formula stretches to the max. Super extended.
Superstar.
Head turning, show stopping lashes. New Superstar Mascara by L'Oreal Makeup Designer, Paris.
Are you ready? You're worth it.
So why do they call it Black Friday anyway?
I don't know, but I think they should call it Pink Friday.
Oh, boy.
And we could have glitter.
Black Friday continues now through Saturday with tons of awesome deals. Toys R Us, a whole store of awesome. Get 50% off Barbie Rockin' Royals limo.
In a world full of dictates and conventions, could there be another way?
Now at Macy's, your fragrance destination.
Come on, he's on down, he's
Mary J. Blige, Queen Latifah, Common, Neo, David Alan Greer, and an all-star cast.
That wasn't my full growl. I'm just giving you a little bit.
The Wiz Live, Thursday, 8, 7 Central on NBC.
My new comedy telenovela is full of what people want. Passion, drama, puppies. There's something for everyone.
This one, Pete, on me.
Telenovela, special preview Monday, December 7th on NBC.
Meet the Rogers family of New Jersey, or at least some of them. Kim and Robert have 9 children. 3 of them, Sophia and the twins, Emma and Faith, are here showing 8 breeds, 17 dogs in all. A Basset Hound here, a Pointer there. A Great Dane, whose size is nearly greater than its handlers.
The best part about the dog shows is not only the dogs, but the people too. It becomes one big giant family.
All right, which is the best dog here?
Oh, they all have their own special little thing.
All right, let me ask you this. Which is the best child here? The youngest Rogers daughter, Julia, is already showing in Pee Wee Juniors. It can't be easy to handle so many dogs and so many handlers. So how about a hand for mom? Because all this is quite a feat.
What a great family story and a great day for Emma, taking fourth with her Bruin. As we move on to the sporting group, David, let's start us off down the line.
32 breeds in the sporting group. Here's the English setter to lead it off. The Gordon setter and the Irish setter. The Irish red and white setter, the 4 setters. Here's the pointer, the German short-haired pointer, the Weimaraner, the Vizsla, the wire-haired Vizsla, the Brittany. Hope you're watching, Grace. The wire-haired pointing Griffon, the Legotto Romagnolo, the new breed, the Spignoni Italiano, the flat-coated retriever, the curly-coated retriever, the golden retriever, the Labrador retriever, tail going, the Nova Scotia duck tolling retriever, the Chesapeake Bay retriever, the Irish water spaniel, the English Springer spaniel, the Welsh Springer spaniel, the field spaniel, the Clumber spaniel, the Sussex spaniel, the English cocker, and the 3 varieties of cocker, the Ascob, the Party, and the Black. The invention of the gun led to the invention of the gun dog to help the hunter. The pointers and setters point and mark the game. The spaniels flush it, and the retrievers bring it back. Although they sort of overlap in their duties with all of those dogs doing all 3 of those functions. 1700s and are one of the most historically interesting breeds. So here's the Gordon setter to lead it off. Gordon's the heaviest setter in bone and substance. That's a little more leisurely than the other setters.
About halfway.
The Duke of Gordon in Scotland established the breed.
Judging the sporting group is Mr. Michael Faulkner. He's assisted by Mike Halstead and Stephen Sansone of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
This is Cedric the Gordon, 6 years old. Number 1 Gordon in the country, multiple best in show winner.
Round the ring, please.
Deirdre Dunbar. Handling the dog from Selkirk, New York. Beautiful dog.
One of my favorite groups watching these dogs work in the ring. Very majestic, elegant dogs.
They have the great temperament that makes them a great gun dog, also makes them a great family dog. This is a wire-haired pointing Griffon, the Griffon we spoke about earlier with some other breeds, first of that lion-like, rough-coated appearance. Who's out in the Brussels Griffon, the PBGV. This is an all-purpose walking gun dog. Loves and needs to hunt. This is Shelby, 2-year-old female. Canine good citizen also, but her father won the breed at the show several times. Voorhees, New Jersey. Kendall DeSanto is the handler. Shelby.
Folks, this is the last, the number 7 of all the new breeds introduced.
Here is our new breed in the sporting group, the Legotto Romagnolo.
This has an interesting story, doesn't it?
Well, they really are. They're the world's foremost truffle hunting dog, and truffles are worth more per ounce than gold. Great delicacy.
and known for the danger they represent. You need a hunter for this, don't you?
Those truffles, huh? Danny Meyer, the famed chef in New York City, Union Square Cafe, Gramercy Tavern, has a Legato Romagnolo. I don't know if he puts it to work or not.
Well, that should get you a free dinner. We'll be back with more of the Sporting Group when we continue.
Isn't it funny that the people you're closest to are also the hardest to shop for? But if you know where to look for inspiration, you can find the perfect gift for everyone on your list. Low prices on everything you need to share wonder every day. Walmart.
I take pictures of sunrises, but with my back pain, I couldn't sleep and get up in time. Then I found Aleve PM.
Aleve PM is the only one to combine a safe sleep aid plus the 12-hour pain-relieving strength of Aleve.
I'm back.
Aleve PM for a better AM.
Spin Brush with a unique dual-action head removes up to 70% more plaque in hard-to-reach places. So give an affordable gift to keep the whole family smiling. Don't just brush, Spin Brush.
Chicago Med is Tuesday's newest hit drama. And this Tuesday,
Dad,
why would a father want to destroy his own son?
He's a screw-up. I want him off the case.
Don't miss the five-star hit, Chicago Med. New Tuesday, and get the NBC app.
Monday morning, get more done with less hassle. Get out the door prepared. See a live look around the country. Access to places roads don't go. Push alerts. Important information fast. Storm Team 5. Let us help you plan your day. Today on 5, WPTV News Channel 5.
The City Mattress Thanksgiving Sale is on now. Get real savings of 10 to 20% below competitor prices. Plus, take advantage of holiday specials throughout the store on everything you need to sleep.
Sleep better and save more. Only at City Mattress.
You can buy unlimited texting for $20 a month. But how much can texting really cost you? Texting while driving can cost you your life. Let's get that message out. The attorneys of Cersei Denny, taking time to care.
It's BrandsMart USA's giant two-day financing event. This weekend only and Sunday at 8 p.m. Pay no interest until 2017 on items throughout the store. It's better than layaway. Take it home now and pay no interest for 18 months. And with our low prices, you'll save even more. Hurry in now and get special financing on TVs, appliances, audio, furniture, computers, tablets, cameras, bedding, home security, and much more. It's BrandsMart USA's giant two-day financing event.
We're empowering families with information to make your money go further.
We share stories specifically to help you.
Reduce monthly expenses. Earn more money. Find better opportunities.
Empowering you to make your money go further on WPTV News Channel 5. Stories that matter to you. Weeknights on WPTV News Channel 5.
He beat me up.
That woman is trying to ruin me. It ends now.
You have messed with the wrong man.
All new Chicago Fire, Tuesday on NBC, and get the NBC app.
Welcome back to the National Dog Show, presented by Purina. This is the Sporting Group and the Curly-Coated Retriever.
One of the oldest retrievers, roots in England. It's that coat texture is more important than having perfect curls, but
halfway down.
Tallest of the retriever breeds. Wickedly smart, and they come in either liver, like this one, or black. This is Skewy. First curly-coated retriever to win a Best in Show in about 30 years. Number one curly, all systems.
You can see the alertness of the breed in the eyes.
Around the ring, please.
Grace Coffrin is the handler, breeder, owner, handler from Brighton, Wisconsin. Beautiful, athletic dog.
Moves beautifully, doesn't it? And here's the one of the most popular dogs in America, the Golden Retriever.
And why wouldn't it be? It's one of the sweetest, happiest, great family dog, hunting dog, trains for obedience well. They don't come with obedience degrees, you know, you got to work at it. But they are so devoted to their people and their owners, it makes them successful at these kinds of things. Eager to please. Gentleman's hunting dog. It moves at kind of a leisurely pace out there. This is Archie, champion Sandman's all in the family. Hence the name Archie. Canine Good Citizen title on it. Jennifer Boyle Grant.
Always love the champion names and then the nicknames. We had a Springer once called Champions Terra's Jingle, and we called her Ding.
Funny stories behind some of the names.
That's right. Cocker Spaniel, this is the Ascot.
Cockers come in three different varieties. A variety is a division of a breed based on coat, color, or size. In Cockers, it's the color. In Poodles, it's the size. Ascot stands for any solid color other than black. But all the Cockers have great eyes. The last dog in the sporting group.
Beautiful coat, isn't it?
Well taken care of. Mr. Faulkner is walking down the line, collecting his thoughts here. Only counting in his mind, he says, I'm going to get about eight dogs out here. Let's see.
Yeah, he brings out the Cocker.
Gets the Ascot out there first. Not sure if he's pulling them in order or not.
Here.
Went right back to the end of the line. So I'm, Gordon maybe Sutter. He's putting them in order a little bit here.
There's a Gordon out there.
So Gordon into the second slot. Wire-haired pointing Griffons right there. Talked about the Griffons, what it means is that hair around the face.
One to the Ascot Cocker, two to the Gordon Sutter, three to the
Well, there were four dogs right there. The winner, you have it. The Ascot, Cocker Spaniel. Beautiful coat, beautiful winner.
The Gordon Sutter was second, the wire-haired pointing Griffon was third, and the curly-coated retriever was fourth.
That's the sporting group. One left to best in show. And backstage, the beat is alive. The moment is here. They're feeling the groove. The non-sporting group is next. And they are jiggy with it.
I can go anyway.
Streaming now.
Some call it giving back. Others call it paying it forward. We call it Share the Love. During the annual Subaru Share the Love event, take home a new Subaru and we'll donate $250 to those in need, bringing our total donations to over $65 million and bringing love where it's needed most. Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
The people closest to you can be the hardest to shop for. But if you know where to look for inspiration, you can find the perfect gift for everyone on your list. And share wonder every day. Walmart.
You still have a chance to win Super Bowl 50 tickets, millions of instant win prizes, and $500,000. But now it's time to give away something everyone can agree on, a free Egg McMuffin. It's time to play Game Time Gold.
Man, I love those bears.
Hey, McMillan, you gelling?
I'm gelling and Zinfandelin, and so's my new bride, Helen McMillan.
I'm so happy my eyes are welling.
Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are so soft, they make your feet feel outrageously comfortable.
I'm gelling.
You're so not gelling.
Dr. Scholl's.
JCPenney's Black Friday sale starts Thursday at 3 p.m. Hurry in to get your special invitation code for a chance to win one of 10 $10,000 cash grand prizes in our $100,000 Black Friday sweepstakes while supplies last. JCPenney, where giving begins.
This is the time for harmony. Let love be the song that everybody sings. Fill the air with joyful noise. Ring the bells and raise your voice. Let there be peace on earth. Let there be peace on earth.
Thanks for making my life so much better, buddy. You rescued me.
Thank you, Wrangler, for bringing that fresh puppy smell to the studio every single morning.
Thank you for being my happy place.
For listening half the time.
For being my champion.
Thank you, Blue.
Thank you, Sadie Mae.
Thank you, Lucy Girl.
Thank you, Dillinger.
Fiona.
Angel and Grace.
I'm Tara Lipinski.
And I'm Johnny Weir.
And we're here to help Purina say thank you to the four-legged champions that win our hearts every single day.
Take a photo, write a message, and upload it to Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram.
And don't forget to use the hashtag dogthanking and @Purina.
For every original post, Purina will donate $1 to the AKC Canine Health Foundation.
A little thank you can make a big difference.
Purina, your pet, our passion. Yes, about dog thanking today. Welcome back to the Greater Philadelphia Expo Center, the home of the National Dog Show presented by Purina. Here we are with our non-sporting lineup, David.
Starting with the standard poodle, here's the Bichon Frise, the Coton de Tulliar, the Lao Chen, the very recognizable Dalmatian, the Sholowitz Squintly,
also recognizable,
the Finnish Spitz, the Kazand, the American Eskimo Dog, the Chinese Shar Pei, the Chow Chow, the Shiba Inu, the Skipper Key, the Lhasa Apso, the Tibetan Spaniel, the Tibetan Terrier, the Boston Terrier, the French Bulldog, and, of course, the Bulldog.
Great crew.
You know, the AKC, when they originally started registering dogs, only had sporting or non-sporting as their categories. And through the years, the Hounds and Terriers split off from the sporting, the toys and working from the non-sporting, and eventually the herding from the working. But the non-sporting is everything that's left, and that's why it's such an eclectic collection of different sizes, shapes, and bodies out there.
Here is the Coton de Tulliar.
They're playing with their feet.
The Coton, of course, was a new breed last year.
Beautiful coat to this dog.
It's a beautiful dog, Burberry.
One of the most remarkable dogs I saw last year.
Very good.
Great temper.
Down and back, please.
Burberry is the number one Coton, all breeds, in the country. With our handler, Ernesto Lara, who we see quite often.
Judging this group, the non-sporting group, Mr. Bob Shreve. Assisted by Ron Scott of the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
Halfway.
Cotons are the royal dog of Madagascar. He first came to France from there. Love this beautiful little white coat, kind of a cottony texture, and a rectangular silhouette, and a concave top line. Convex top line, excuse me.
Good. All the way around, please.
There you see the Coton. It's second year of competition here. Little cotton swab of a dog.
As I said, recognizable for the fact that this one has no hair. This is the Sholowitz Squintly.
Goes right to the other extreme, looking right at you and through you.
Mm-hmm. Great shot right there, huh?
You're the national dog of Mexico. Was known as the Mexican Hairless for many years, but they're descended from prized Aztec dogs. Their role in their history, in their religious history, is as a guardian of the dead. This is Manny. Champion Bayshore Stonehaven Manny Machado. I think Manny is a baseball player somewhere. I think he's with the Orioles, in fact.
Imagine ordering a pizza
all the way around, please.
Best in show winner, number one Sholo, all breeds, and is a son of the great Giorgio Armani, who was the top winning Sholo in history. Here's the Kazand. Here's the look that you get with the smiling Dutchman, it's called, and spectacles around the eyes make them look like they're wearing glasses. Those lines.
Show me the bite, please.
The corner of the eye to the ear.
Let's go down and back. About halfway.
These were the barge mascots in Holland. The legend is that they would be on boats working in the dense fog and the dogs would bark back and forth. Let the bargemen know exactly where they were. This is Happy. whose picture represents the caisson in all the AKC breed standards. That's a pretty good honor.
Good. All the way around.
Wade Coyston and Handling. Happy, four-year-old. Two best in shows. Number two caisson in the country. Very nice. Happy.
Beautiful dog. We'll be back right after this.
Behind every open heart is a story. A story about finishing the race, no matter what the obstacles. About rebuilding the bond between a mother and a daughter. Or about helping build homes for others because you remember what it felt like not to have one. When you keep an open heart, amazing things happen. That's what the Open Hearts Collection at Kay Jewelers is all about.
Right now, save up to 20% on select Open Hearts jewelry at Kay.
Keep your heart open, and love will always find its way in.
Every kiss begins with Kay.
How effective is Arm & Hammer Clump & Seal Lightweight?
As a pet sitter, I deal with litter all day. This is amazing on odor. It's really easy to carry, and there's no dust.
No other litter seals and destroys odor and is 50% lighter and 100% dust-free. Try Clump & Seal Lightweight.
The holidays bring many challenges to the feet. By day, they must stay warm, but by night, beautiful, smoother, and ready to impress the other party animals. Dr. Scholl's Dreamwalk Express Petty.
Lisa!
Took you so long.
DuraCell Quantum lasts longer in 99% of devices, so you can power imagination all day long.
Not getting your best sleep? Could be you've got the wrong bed. Enter Sleep Number. She likes the bed soft. He's more hardcore. You can both adjust the bed for the best sleep of your life. Only at a Sleep Number store. Save 50% on the Ultimate Limited Edition bed. Hurry, sale ends Monday. No better sleep with Sleep Number.
Stuff your stockings with big savings at Lowe's. Hurry in today for great Black Friday deals on all of your holiday gifts.
Ooh.
Now get this 20-volt DeWalt or Porter cable drill for only $99 each.
So why do they call it Black Friday anyway?
I don't know, but I think they should call it Pink Friday.
Oh, boy.
And we could have glitter.
Black Friday continues now through Saturday with tons of awesome deals. Toys R Us, a whole store of awesome. Get our favorite family board games, just $5 each.
Oh, Harold, that was awful.
It wasn't me, it was the dogs. Blamed.
Again.
You dealt it. You own it, human.
Enough is enough.
We're not going to take it anymore.
Revolution. Revolution. Revolution.
I gotta tell you, all this revolutioning is making me tired.
Okay, nap first, then revolution.
Agreed.
Hey, humans, relieve your gas fast with Dulco gas.
But stop blaming us.
Thursday.
You gotta kill the Wicked Witch of the West.
Queen Latifah, Common, and Mary J. Blige.
I hate water!
The Wiz Live, Thursday on NBC.
This is what dogs do when the whole world is watching. But what do they do?
Any plans today?
Yes, big, big stuff today, Gidget.
When no one is watching. Discover the secret life of cats.
You'd be a good boy, Leonard.
In theaters this summer. And now, back to the show.
Yes!
From the humans behind Despicable Me comes a comedy about the lives our pets lead when we're not around. Discover the secret life of pets in theaters on July 8th.
Oh, I look forward to that one.
Yes, and here's the Chow Chow, which is anything but Gabby Gabby.
They are very quiet, unless you want to hear them talk to you here.
That's the purr of a lion or a cat. I don't know. What is it?
You see that blue-black tongue? They have to have that tongue. They're telling the judge all about it.
That's right.
You know, they're not all fluff under all that coat. They're pretty powerful dogs.
Nice.
They've been a hunting dog or herding
Please
dog.
Take him down and back.
Came to us from southern China. Come in a variety of colors and a smooth or a rough coat, like the rough coat here. Beautiful dog. One of the oldest breeds, probably. This is Dez. He's 4 years old. He's a one-of-a-kind Chow Chow. He's raised two children in his lifetime. Kylie, age 3, and Logan, just 10 months, but he's like a nanny dog to them.
All the way around.
Jan Kalnick Handling. Very nice.
Yeah, very good looking chap.
And here's our Lhasa Apso. From Tibet, of course, from Lhasa, Tibet. That's where the name comes from.
Guardians of the temple.
The lion dog as a watchdog, yes. They teamed with the mastiffs to guard the living quarters. The mastiff was outside and sounded the alarm. Started in this country, actually, in the terrier group in the mid-30s. They're one of three breeds in this group from Tibet, along with a Tibetan Spaniel and a Tibetan Terrier. But the military brought them out of Tibet to England. From there, they came to this country. This is Penny, 2 years old, from Watertown, Connecticut, handled by Laura Rock, who's the owner-handler. Penny's favorite junk food is French fries. Lovely dog. It's a lot of coat, a lot of work. It's a great texture to the coat.
Great companion dogs.
Wonderful dogs. Lhasa Apso. This is Penny. And our last dog in the non-sporting group is the French Bulldog. Very popular these days.
It has become a very popular dog, hasn't it? Yeah?
And rightfully so. They've got this wonderful personality. They're a bit clownish. Their trademark is that flat skull there and those bat ears.
Kind enough to show me the bite.
Primary breed traits, yes. The judge is asking to show the bite. Come in a variety of colors.
Down and back. Halfway.
Very sweet dog. They're not really like the bulldog as far as expression goes. They don't really look pugnacious or challenging.
Very popular apartment dogs. See quite a few of these in cities around the country.
And in fact, this dog, Ruby, comes from New York City. It's owner Patricia Hurst Shaw. And Patricia was also the owner of Frida, the Frenchie that won the group here last year. So here's Ruby, 2-year-old female. Beautiful little dog, fun dog. Jody Longmire handling. Become a very popular breed in this country.
He's making his cut now.
Let's see Frenchie, you'll be number one.
Oh, he's not made his cut. He's made his choice.
Kayshan, you're number three.
The Frenchie was number one.
He went right to it, didn't he?
Without the cut.
The Coton de Tuléar is second. The Kayshan was third, and the Lhasa Apso was fourth. A very nice group.
It's a great group indeed, and our final group. Before we go to Best in Show, there's your class of 2015. Who will be Best in Show? Backstage, they are ready. Last-minute coaching, a little bit of grooming, and don't sit this one out. Best in Show is up next.
Now earn 10% cash back at Amazon with Chase Freedom through December. Chase Freedom, the card is for the essentials. The cash back is for the fun. Learn more at chase.com/freedom. Chase, so you can.
This Saturday at Kohl's, take an extra 20% off with your savings pass. Use it in store and online. And get sleepwear and loungewear for just $7.99 each. For men and women, for girls and boys, for everyone in the family. Saturday only. Plus, only once a year, get $15 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. Use your extra 20% off savings pass this Saturday when you shop Kohl's and Kohl's.com.
Sunday night, Tom Brady and the undefeated Patriots square off with the Broncos. Sunday night is football night, only on NBC.
This is my new mattress from Haverty's. I'm waking up so refreshed now. I used to be a bit groggy in the morning. Those were dark days.
Wake up refreshed on a mattress from Haverty's. Save up to $300 instantly on a Tempur-Breeze mattress. Plus, enjoy 60-month no-interest financing. Haverty's. Discover something new.
Black Friday starts now.
This sale is gonna be GOAT.
What is GOAT?
Greatest of all time.
GE Profile and GE Cafe. Two hot brands with huge price reductions.
The deals are so hot, you'll be saying hashtag I love Rosners.
We'll see you soon for our huge Black Friday price reduction sale on all GE appliances.
Selfie! More of what you're looking for.
City Furniture's Black Friday sale has just been extended through Monday. Get incredible specials in the showroom and on cityfurniture.com. A complete queen bedroom, $9.99. A power reclining sectional, $12.99. A five-piece dining set, $5.99. Plus, enjoy free shipping and an extra 10% off or no interest till 2020. Through Monday at City Furniture.
A foggy night on Lover's Lane, where two sweethearts planned a romantic rendezvous. But someone else had other ideas.
I just went into complete shock.
Dateline, don't watch alone.
Welcome back to the National Dog Show presented by Purina. This is what we have been waiting for all day. Best in show.
And here's our seven group winners at the National Dog Show presented by Purina. From the working group, it's the Newfoundland. From the hound group, it's the Scottish Deerhound. From the herding group, the Bearded Collie. From the sporting group, the Ascob Cocker Spaniel. From the terrier group, the Skye Terrier. From the non-sporting group, the French Bulldog. And from the toy group, it's the Smooth Chihuahua. Seven great group winners.
Indeed. A great group today. The judge is being introduced right now. This is Ms. Beth Swiper.
All right, do it again.
Assisted Thanks. By Frank DiPaolo with the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
Give a little smile there. She's got a beautiful lineup. She should be smiling.
Special area of expertise. She has to know each one of these breeds that represent seven different groups, David.
From the 1,763 dogs that started the day, we're down to the final seven. Breed winners, group winners, and now the final lineup. Who's going to be best in show from those 1,700 dogs of more than 180 different breeds? Let's see, people are clapping as she steps in front of their favorite. Got a nice variety there in addition to nice quality. A little bit of everything for somebody.
Right, here comes the Newfoundland.
There's Winslow the Newfoundland, owned by Scott Rainey and Jenny Lengel and Christine Gorsuch from Alexandria, Virginia.
He's a big old bear, isn't he?
Yes. Handler Michael Scott. The breeder is Ginny Lengel and Wendy Heyman. The Newfoundland. Turf tides breezing up at Barren Mind. With a bunch of titles at the end of its name for agility and a bunch of other performance sports. A balanced dog, we say, has titles at both ends. Okay, so look at that face. Please. Michael Scott, the handler. Coming right into your living room here. Give him a little piece of turkey when he stops. Very nice. Dogs in great weight.
Okay,
they're not as heavy as you might think anyway. They're about 150 pounds or so, which sounds like a lot, of course, but...
Still very much a lap dog.
Yes. The champion swimmer of the dog world. So they'll bring some of that water back to your lap at any moment in time.
Here is the Scottish Deerhound. Great looking dog as well.
This is Chelsea, grand champion, Fox Cliffs Chelsea Piers, owned by Cecilia Dove and Dr. Scott Dove. They are the breeders, along with Sarah Sweat. Angela Lloyd is the handler. Chelsea's mother, Hickory, was best in show at Westminster in 2011. the winner of the Hound Group, Chelsea. Beautiful Scottish Deerhound. They are supposed to have an easy active gait. You can see that here. Rough-coated greyhound, very similar.
Very good. Around to the end for me.
Another dog that doesn't do so much what it was originally bred to do, that is to hunt antlered game. It's outlawed in this country, but they still have the tendency and the personality to do that. And that's important for the judge to know and see.
And the clubs support that by field trials and things of that nature to keep the breed true to its specification. And here is the bearded collie.
We've had a bearded collie go best in show here before. So why not this one? This is Zach, Grand Champion Dunhill's Steeler Nation. Owned by Scott and Valerie Schaefer and Ray and Kathy Harrington, who are also the breeders, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Katie Shepherd is the handler. The winner of the herding group, the bearded collie.
Get down with that for me, please.
So we'll get, well, there's our bounce. We knew we'd get one last one here. This dog moves beautiful, doesn't
he? He's a nice moving dog. The coat complements the movement well. Judge moves them down and back to look at them coming and going, their movement. And she'll watch the side gate as she takes them around the ring to the end.
Okay, around to the end, please.
There you go.
Just enough to mess up about 20 minutes of tough grooming.
And draw a great response from the crowd. It's still SRO here. Speaking of great grooming, the Ascob, Cocker Spaniel.
All the way from Kennewick, Washington, it's Matt. Grand Champion Blondim's Easy Matters. Multiple best in show, number one Ascob. Owned and bred by Sherry and Barry Blondim from Kennewick, Washington. Lisa Arnett is the handler.
What you can't see won't hurt you.
Down and back for me, please.
They pull the ears up like that so the judge can get a good, clean look at the neck. Mm-hmm. How the neck is set into the shoulders, length of neck. But it's smooth and flowing the way it's supposed to be. Here's Matt.
This is a beauty. This is a beauty. The tea color of the coat is just remarkable.
It's called buff. Again, an Ascob Cocker, any solid color other than black. One of three varieties in Cockers. There's Matt. Look at the dog go. Mm-hmm. Wow, very nice.
Speaking of well-groomed.
This dog is immaculate.
Isn't it? Skye Terrier.
Beautiful dog. Top winning dog. Deservedly so.
Started off today with this dog. As a winner.
The Skye Terrier. Champion Cragsmore, Good Time Charlie. With 78 best in shows. Let's see if we can get number 79 today, perhaps. The owners are Victor Malzoni and Nancy Shaw. The breeders are Gene Zafiris and Matt Stander. Laird Cornelius is the handler.
How distinct are these markings here with the dark ears and the great tone to the coat?
Well, it gives them a great look. They're supposed to be long, low, and level. And the coloring, of course, brings out those ears and the facial features. But this dog is a wonderful show dog. Great specimen. They have to start by being a great specimen of their breed, but then they have to have a little something extra in the ring. A little showmanship, pizzazz. Call it whatever you want.
And you mentioned the coat complementing the movement of the dog. Certainly indicative here, huh?
Absolutely.
Thank you. Right around.
This dog's had a lot of big wins in its past. Let's see if it can add this one. The Skye Terrier, Charlie. Mm-hmm. Speaking of fun-loving, here we have the Frenchie.
Suspicious little look. Our faces are so expressive.
Ruby from New York City, New York. Got finalists from six different states across the country, far away as Washington, Missouri, Florida, Pennsylvania, Virginia. This is Ruby. Champion Iacta Alia Est de la Bet. How about my Latin? Never had Latin in high school. Five bests in shows.
I remember Agricola and Agricola. I think I nod out at that. Here we come. There's the distinctive little move with the Frenchie.
Owned by Patricia Hurst from New York and Dr. Peter Fotis and Blake Hammond from Attleboro, Massachusetts, who are also the breeders. Jody Longmire is the handler. Here's Ruby.
Thank you, ma'am. Right around for me.
You gotta love a Frenchie. They're so sweet. Great clowns. Lots of fun. Yeah. Coming right at you.
What do you think, Mom? We got this locked up?
And the last dog in the lineup.
And certainly not least, although never prove it by a chihuahua. They got big hearts.
They think they're a big dog. They line up the dogs in the final lineup by size. So when they run them around together, they're not running over slower dogs in front of them. So the smallest dog, the chihuahua, is in the back of the line. It's our last dog. It's a Sonito, top-winning chihuahua of all time, owned by Janet Lang Moses and Jim Moses and Dr. Romulo Torres Sanchez from Mexico City, Mexico, who's also the breeder. Erica Lanasa is the handler. For Sonito.
Thank you, ma'am. Right around.
This is a great-looking little dog, isn't it?
Love this dog.
Oh, that's right.
Great personality, beautifully presented, as are all these dogs.
Yeah, you can hear it from the crowd.
Look at him go.
Yeah. They've all had their chance, David. What do you like?
Well, I love the Skye Terrier. I think he's going to be pushed by the Chihuahua, who I also love. And it's a great lineup. I like them all.
I'd like to see you one at a time around to the end of the line, please. Stopping back here.
One more run through the ring here.
One of those lineups that I like to jokingly say the judge can just close her eyes and point and have a great winner. And that's the way it should be at a show like this.
This is a beautiful Newfoundland. David, I think this is one of the prettier ones that I've seen in the history of the show. That Newfoundland is gorgeous.
Beautiful, beautiful dog. How could he get here without being napped? There's the Scottish Deerhound from the Hound Group, this bearded collie from the herding group. The sporting group, it's the Ascob Cocker Spaniel.
One last run.
The Skye Terrier. A little more leisurely pace than the others, but proper speed. Looks great. All these dogs are beautifully presented by their handlers. And the French Bulldog gets a little chuckle from you and a lot of other people, I think.
Inside he's saying, I think this is a lock. I think I got it.
And there's the top-winning chihuahua in history.
This really is a wonderful grouping.
A very nice lineup.
Each one makes you smile.
And that's the way it should be with dogs in our lives. All of you, before Beth picks her Best in Show winner, lean over and hug the dog sitting on the couch next to you and tell them that they are your Best in Show dog.
It is all about dog thanking today. There they are. While they await the judge's decision.
Take one last look for you at home. Pick your winner at home. It's okay for you to judge from outside the ring, too. We do it all the time. I don't always agree with the judge's decisions from where I sit.
That's right. You and I are going to decide this in the parking lot.
Thank you for bringing such a lovely
lineup. Here we go.
Tonight, I was really thrilled to have everyone. And Best in Show tonight is the Skye Terrier.
The Skye Terrier, Best in Show.
How about that? The beautiful Skye Terrier, his 79th Best in Show.
It was Charlie's day. Nearly 1,800 dogs started out today One is Best in Show, the Skye Terrier. Mary's going to be with the winner in just a moment. Stay with us.
I'd like to see more of the old lady. I'd like to see her go back to her more, you know, social side. Maybe see if it's something has an effect on her social side. She literally started changing. It was shocking. The difference has been incredible. She's much more aware.
A brighter look to her eyes. Mm-hmm. She loves the food.
She wants to learn things. I went in as not a believer, but I am now. I don't know. She's a good dog.
You're getting a bit emotional there.
Yeah.
Purina Pro Plan Bright Mind promotes alertness and mental sharpness in dogs 7 and older. Purina Pro Plan, nutrition that performs.
Intel's best processor is here, and it helps PCs wake up instantly, just like you did.
That's great, but do you mind?
No, I don't mind.
Introducing Intel's new 6th generation core processor. It's our best processor ever.
Life ensures that when things can't possibly get worse, they always do. Life needs Ziploc.
SC Johnson. What if the holidays were about people again? And the four-letter word that defined the season was L-O-V-E and not S-A-L-E. That's the world TJ Maxx, Marshalls, and HomeGoods stores live in. Where there's no need for sales because we offer amazing prices on thoughtful gifts every day. Let's put more value on what really matters. This season, bring back the holidays with TJ Maxx, Marshalls, and HomeGoods.
Monday on The Voice, it's down to the top 10.
How great to have this moment right now.
Giving you 10 reasons to vote. 10 reasons to instantly save an artist's dream.
He kind of got it all, actually.
Then, it's a special preview of Superstore. You've shopped there. Maybe you've even worked there.
Let's put our best foot forward, okay?
And Sal, I'm going to need you to take the creepiness down to about a 2.
The Superstore special preview, right after The Voice live. It all starts Monday at 8, 7 Central on NBC.
Throwback Thursday on this Thanksgiving Day. Here's a shot of our winner, Charlie, as a puppy. Mary Carrillo, you're with our winner now.
With Larry Cornelius, Charlie's handler. I love how Charlie was sniffing the trophy. Does he know it's his?
Yeah, he does. He wants to make sure he's not going to mark his territory, but he wants to check out his loot anyway.
This is the 79th Best in Show that this dog has won. What makes Charlie so special?
I'm kind of biased, but I think he's an exceptional show dog. The breed isn't necessarily known for being a good show dog, but he really gives his heart every time I show him. And I think he's got the three things you want in a Skye are long, low, and level. And I think he has that.
Long, low, and level?
Long, low, and level.
I like that. Congratulations to both of you.
Thank you, Mary. And as a reminder, if you go online to nationaldogshow.com, you can watch the video of all 180 breeds from this year's show. Coming up next, it's Dateline, and Sunday night is football night. We'll be in Denver as Tom Brady and the Patriots take on the Broncos on Sunday Night Football. Coverage begins at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, only on NBC. For Mary Carrillo, Johnny Weir, Tara Lipinski, and my co-host David Frei, this is John O'Hurley saying goodbye, everyone, and happy Thanksgiving.
This is an NBC News special report. Here's Lester Holt.
Good evening. We're coming on the air right now to update you on a story we've been following much of the day, the deadly siege at a Planned Parenthood clinic in Colorado Springs, Colorado. Authorities say three people were killed in the standoff, two civilians and one police officer, after a gunman stormed the building and engaged in a prolonged battle with police. At least nine people were injured, four of them civilians, and five police officers. Officials say they are in good condition. About 5 hours after he stormed the building, the gunman surrendered and was taken into custody. As a police SWAT team fought with the shooter, many people who were in the building were led to safety in a series of dramatic rescues. Tonight, the police are analyzing items the gunman may have left behind. a process they say will take hours or even days to repeat. A five-hour standoff is over tonight in Colorado Springs with a gunman in custody and three people, including a police officer, dead. More on the Colorado shooting on your late local news. And now we take you to Dateline.